Welcome back. The Directorate of Municipal Administration has begun inquiry in the CCP ward delimitation confusion. DMA has ordered the Mamladar to conduct inquiry. The report will be submitted to the DMA. Around 200 voters from Borbat, Shankarwadi and Wadlebat who voted for Taligaon Panchayat elections are shifted to CCP voters list. Prudent had exposed this mess on Tuesday.
Soon after Prudence exposure over the Corporation of City of Panchi's delimitation, Directorate of Municipal Administration has started its inquiry. Around 100 voters of Taligaon Panchayat from Borbat, 40 each from Shankarwadi and Wadlebat are now been included in the CCP election voters list. According to the law, in such cases, government has to issue notification. However, no such step was taken by the government. Now DMA has started inquiry in this matter. This Wadi Mamladar has been ordered to conduct inquiry and submit the report. The inquiry will be held in part number 36, 38 and 18. Mamladar's report is expected within 2 days. Sources say there is only one option left now. Government is yet to make the electoral roll public. Government has faced saver can delete this lately added names. But with this, the number of voters from ward number 17 will be decreased. As of now, there are 892 voters in this ward. Reporter Mahesh Ghadi with video journalist Omkar Farari for Prudent.
Congress Party has shown paranoia while forming its Fathorda Block Committee with as many as 8 vice presidents and 12 general secretaries. When Prudent compared Fathorda Block level committee with their other block committees, we found that Congress has gone overboard in Fathorda. The main agenda is clear: to pin down incumbent MLA Vijay Saradesai in his own constituency.
GPCC has recently formed their Fathorda Block Committee. Surprisingly, they have scored double century while forming this block. Total 206 members, including office bearers, are part of this magnanimous block committee. This is the overall structure of the Fathorda Congress Block Committee. One president, 8 vice presidents, 12 general secretaries, 5 secretaries, 3 joint secretaries, 1 treasurer, and 176 members. Total 206 membered block committee. Now let's have a look at the Congress Block Committee in some of the other constituencies which seem to be normal information. We have taken data of block committees from MAPSA, which consists of 25 members with 5 to 7 office bearers. Panji committee consists of 25 members with 5 to 7 office bearers. In the Navelim Block Committee of GPCC President Luisin Falero, there are 25 members, 1 president, 2 vice presidents, 1 secretary, 1 treasurer, and rest are members. Same with the Walpoy, 1 president, 2 vice presidents, 1 secretary, and 1 treasurer with 25 members. Congress has maintained a standard pattern while forming all their block committees. Block committees have never crossed the figure of 30 members altogether. They also follow reservation pattern in which 33% is reserved for women. Reservation for OBC, ST is also followed while forming these committees. But while forming the Fathorda Block Committee, the panic and the paranoia of Congress seems to be very much clear. Bureau Report, Prudent.
In today's time, it is required to humanize our law. Retired Judge of the Supreme Court, Justice B.N. Srikrishna, was speaking at the function of first death anniversary of former Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court, Justice G.D. Kamat, at Institute Menezes Braganza at Panji. On this occasion, Justice Mahesh Sonak remembered the human-friendly nature of late Justice G.D. Kamat.
An oration program was held at Institute Menezes Braganza on the occasion of first death anniversary of former Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court, Justice G.D. Kamat. Justice G.D. Kamat was the first Goan to become a Chief Justice of any High Court in the country. Justice Mahesh Sonak said that Justice Kamat always rendered justice in true means and always encouraged young advocates.
Chief Justice Kamat really humanized the law. He had robust common sense, which is quite a rare commodity nowadays. He had immense good heart. And these were his two jurisprudential markers. Chief Justice Kamat never forgot that behind the mass of case papers that are thrust upon a judge, there is always a human face which is crying for justice.
Chief guest of the function, retired judge of the Supreme Court, Justice B.N. Srikrishna, said that legal fraternity should not only protect the law but also see the human angle while delivering the justice.
What is a human right? A human right is the real human face of law.
It is not a right that is granted by anybody. Any right that is granted by anybody can always be taken away. Parliament may legislate today and said, I have a right to do ABC. Tomorrow another parliament may abolish that and say, I do not have a right to do ABC. Now, we are seeing this quite often, whether you have a right to eat this kind of food or that kind, do this kind of activity or carry on this kind of dress. It has now become a matter of adjudication, if probably even laws passed against it. But a human right is something that is inalienable to a human being.
GD Kamath Charitable Trust felicitated Advocate Manohar Usgaonkar and Advocate Jai Singh Maganlal for the excellent contribution for Goan Legal Society. Reporter Mukesh Kumar with Tukaram Marathi for Prudent.
Let's take a short break. Stay tuned.